right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, take control, take dominion, and take charge in this environment. Take charge and take dominion in this environment now. Take charge and take dominion in this environment. Saturate this place with your Holy Spirit. Saturate this place with your power. Allow this environment to be so heavy of your presence. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Allow the Holy Spirit to operate on you.
about evil voters. But I want us to pray once again right now. I just want you to say, my Father, my Father. Those are the evil waters that you are speaking about. Those are the evil waters that you are speaking about.
I want us to pray violently. I want us to pray violently.
Shut up!
So I've been a person who has been mentored by the evangelist. I've had my daughter who just got sick. You know, every woman who has had a child knows how it is to have a child sick. But through her leading prayers and verses, I just find myself finding the time and the words. And whenever I am in tough situations, I just find the time to just send a message to her and say, hey, evangelist, I have got such a problem. And then she gives me the word. It doesn't matter how busy I am at work. I'll be working, but I'll be praying. I cannot tell you how blessed I feel, how honored I feel, how sure I am that God is alive. God is alive every day, yesterday, today, and tomorrow. God is my rock, God is my pillar, God is my strength. I thank you, woman of God, for being my mentor. I thank you for taking your time. Even if I sent her a message at midnight, I know even if she doesn't read it there and then, she will respond maybe 2 hours or the next morning I'll be having my reply. And then I walk confidently because the Lord holds my right hand. I thank you, the Lord. I thank him for wiping my tears. I thank him for making me enter into 2019. I left my daughter well. She just developed a pain and a swelling on, and the doctor was saying, I'm going to operate because I think the op which took out the twins was not sewn properly. And I knelt down and said, not in the name of the Lord, this is not going to happen. When she went for the scan, there was nothing which was found, and she's up and about and going to be.
Hallelujah! Amen! I want to thank the Lord so much. My first testimony is to see the woman of God and the man of God as well as you be greeted. Hallelujah! And also the man of God.
Hallelujah!
People of God, I just want to thank this God because of the other type of woman. I joined the group in 2018. Is in Cape Town. I'm based in Eastern Cape. Hallelujah. Since then, I actually saw the hand of God. I learned how to pray. I want to thank God because of our evangelist. I've been in her inbox time and again. And I thank God. Sometimes I still remember my sister was saying, why is it that when you write a message, she quickly replies you? Is it because of the name? Because of the favor of God, just to pray, write a message and pray. By the way, my name is Cynthia Dube. This is Mkwachi. Hallelujah. So I want to thank the Lord so much because my passion was to come to Bulawayo of the holiday. And because I had a child who is on this side. So I had many problems which were forcing me to stay there in Eastern Cape, South Africa for a long time without coming to this side. But I want to thank God because evangelists, at one time declared when we were having our Esther fasting that you have to write down your goals that by the end of 2019 I should have this and that. My major challenge was part of a business, to have a business. Hallelujah. And I remember at one time when I was saying, God, which business can I start? God just gave me a revelation of wheat. And I said, but I'm not a hairdresser, I can't even do that thing. But because God had spoken something through the woman of God, that thing would surely come to pass. So what I'm doing right now, I'm having a hairdresser who is in Johannesburg, who is making the wheels for me and supplying me, and I'm selling them. And the level which that thing are bought is so amazing. Hallelujah. Even during my absence, but my husband is staying in Eastern Cape. Every time people are actually communicating with me through WhatsApp, they are putting orders. They are going there to pay those who are owing me. They are paying something.
challenge and mina wangu wanzishieza matu. So I said Msiswaza manataka kuapply a nursing shikurame, teaching shikurame, nursing shikurame. But what Msiswaza told me is, we still know that I am not. But I'm becoming a message that you expect, which I still is a couple of three kids. 6 months down the line, in 2019, una June, we know what about what I do. Tourism industry, and I'm going to get the tourism, but she's now boss. I mean boss, whom I yes no like her. She's enjoying. I thank you, I thank you.
Then 20 last year.
as a junior, things were not easy.
Na manetu wa supervisor.
Yese wa nikuno kuma seniors haa. Saka ya speaker ina wa supervisor kwa sapele. Mwalika na mitila nyaki. Shaka huma, shaka tani. God is born again.
Whatever is taking place, whatever, my outers, it's a pakati patakani matum outers. Kumbakwa njino kara, nye leta na ishi. Almost every week, she liya ipinda, chichi zingirira, every week. But patakati mwema outers, yuma nakati shiri hii, nunga na ichipinda mwema. Nga hii mwufira mwema nasi. Takamuka ni wanea kafa. Then last week, after the first time, wanao na nunga, yaka hii niki jai. Mandakao na nunga, katumari, what's going on? Life. But that will not join in my life. Every letter shall not be the number one of my time. Amen.
Not just an issue of registration.
were tendering with the government. And currently, as I'm speaking, I'm working with the Chinese who are building Lupane State University, who are building Lupane, the upcoming Lupane Hospital. Because it's a long time left, but I'm feeling something like that. And as if it was not enough, I struggled in marriage. I said to God, God, I don't know if I was supposed to be in this marriage or not. But if I'm supposed to be in that marriage, and you want me to take it, if I'm not supposed to be there, you said you're the father of the fatherless, you're the husband to those who do not have husbands, God provides for you. As hard as 2019 was, everyone was pregnant, prices are going up, everything was just going up, and things were so bad for everyone. I don't even remember a single day that I can say, I did not get this because I did not have money. I do not have problems with money, and I'm working hard, I'm finishing my degree, and everything is falling in line. Thank you so much, Swazi.
She inboxed me and she said I must be the person, so does 40.
verses 24 to 28. She was saying, I'm seeing your enemies drowning. Remember the Egyptians when they were crossing the Red Sea. In my mind, I don't know what God was happening, but I just prayed about it. And then on the 23rd of October, on the 23rd of December, my friend, at the ceremony at church, it was beautiful. And then we went and took photos. After the photos, when we're coming back now, we went at the wall. And I parked my car. I remember it being on, the reverse was there, the gear was on, the brakes were on, and the keys were off. We actually stood there next to the car. If the car was supposed to move, you know how it is for those who drive. If you don't leave your brakes on, and naturally when you step out of the car, you should move right there. We stood for about 20 to 30 minutes outside the car. When it was time for us to get into the wall, I always remember one of the pastors saying, when the devil wants to do something to you, he will isolate you from everyone. When everyone was now inside the wall, when I went to my car to close the window, I closed the other side of the window, and then when I was now coming to the driver's side, all of a sudden the car moved. Now I was shocked, what's happening? My car moved to the, one of the, there were no kids inside. The brakes were still on. The brakes and the handbrake. They were still on. There were no car keys in the ignition. It just started moving. And it moved to the left side, where there was the pastor's car. It was a pickup car. So it went to the point whereby it squashed me in the door. It started squashing me. I don't know, but I remember it was a nice prayer point, because ever since I started praying in the group in 2019, late 2019, I started praying those prayer points. I don't know where I got the courage, but I just said, God, I cannot die in this waiting. Because I was now taking my last breath. I was squashed through all those four parts, the door. I couldn't even breathe, but I just kept on praying. I was like, no, God, I will not die. This can't be the end of me, not here. Not in this waiting. And then people started coming, and I realized, you know, the Holy Spirit is always there. People can come, they can try and save you, but at the end of the day, only God can help you. Because people came around, but they couldn't move me. No one could move me. All of a sudden, I just saw this top part moving, and everyone was shocked. What's happening? Are you feeling pain? But I only, this part of my leg was the only thing that was left. So I stayed there for almost 20 minutes while they were trying to remove the side, and then they lifted the car. All of a sudden I was out. And I was like, this can only be God. Because if it was not God, that would have been the end of me. So I just want to thank God in Watanai for your prayers, for the prayer points that I get every day. I am here today because of the prayer points and for help. Thank you so much.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to thank God for all the testimonies. I just met a lot of people who testified saying, when they texted me and they replied with their face, some of them were disappointed. Could say, how can she reply me with her face when I sent my prayer request? All I want to tell you is, I cannot make a better prayer than the one God. I think when you create a prayer in line for a chocolate, that is the reason why I usually respond with a scripture. That scripture says it all. It answers and addresses everything that you do with. So if you text me and I respond with a scripture, just meditate on that scripture. Pray with that scripture.